Hey guys, back with a new review, and today I'm doing kind of a two-in-one. This is officially the end of my Halloween reviews for this year. I have more stuff coming, it's just it didn't make it by the deadline, so they're not officially Halloween reviews. But this is also kind of a Toy Story review. For those of you who follow me on Twitter, I mentioned months ago that I had acquired something to really make my Toy Story collection pop, or something to that extent. I think only a few people actually caught on to what it was, and I never officially said what it was, I don't think. Well, what I got was the musical Jolly Chimp. Now, this is kind of a hard review to do. This is pretty much just a showcase kind of thing, I think. You can't really review something like this. You can show its features off, and that's really about it. But this is the musical Jolly Chimp made by Daishin, I believe it's pronounced. I'm probably wrong. And I think this is the second version of the whole cymbal banging monkey thing. Really, really big toys. I think mine is from the 1950s to 1960s, roughly. But it's definitely the oldest toy in my collection. And it's really opened me up to the antique toys of when my parents were children. I really want to get more because of this thing. I really do like it. But here's the box. I don't know what all is really included in the box. When I got mine, it was the box with the styrofoam peanuts with the monkey in it. That's it. But on the side, you have the little instructions here. Put batteries in his butt, flip the switch, watch him bang his cymbals. And on mine, the cymbals bang, his head will bob. And then when you tap his head, he will bare his teeth and screech and growl while his eyes bulge at you. Which just makes him oh so creepy. But nice little cartoon image. It's a nice, friendly looking toy. It's definitely not exact how the actual thing looks. So let's get this out of the way. And the reason I'm calling this kind of a Halloween review is because this thing has appeared in numerous horror, suspense, thriller kind of movies. Kind of horror. Stephen King did a short story about it. There's a movie called Monkey Shines. All kinds of things. And the reason is because this thing is extremely creepy. Not so much now, but when it gets in the full effect. Now also, for those of you who are watching this, if there is somebody who's an expert on this toy, and I mean an expert, you know the ins and outs, you know everything about it, I would love to get your opinion on the overall condition of mine. I think it's in pretty good condition, but there's a few things I'm unsure about. So if you are an expert, if you know someone who's an expert on vintage antique toys, if you could have them look at this and give me their thoughts, their opinions, I would greatly appreciate it. Mine, for instance, I know there's some paint scraping off his fingers. I know there's some like dirt spots on his trousers. There's a hole that's forming in his head that I think I could get my mom to patch up. She's really good at stitching and that kind of stuff. I think she could maybe fix that. And that's really all I know as far as like cosmetic kind of stuff. I'm unsure about his features, whether he's 100% mint or if he's got some issues or not. The way this thing works, battery compartment here, open this up, 2D batteries go in, lock him up. There's a battery switch, or there's an on-off switch on his back. When you turn that on, he'll bang his cymbals, he'll bob his head. And then when you tap his head, or on mine, I have to push kind of hard because, well, I don't know why really. I have to push kind of hard, but then he will bare his teeth, he'll screech while his eyes are bulging at you. Not every version of this toy will have all those features. This one has all those, that's why I wanted it. There are newer versions, there are older versions. I think the newest one is the Charlie Chimp that you can get for like 35 bucks, and I'll post a link in the video description to where you can get that. It's not going to look like him, but it should have all the features, and I think it'll look good for collection if you don't want to shout the money to get this thing. These things can go for a lot of money. I think mine, with the flaws that it has, went for a bit cheaper than I really thought it would go. And that's really all I can say. I'm going to turn it on. Now, I've seen videos of this on YouTube. I've seen quite a number of videos. And I'm really unsure how mine fits in with how it's supposed to be. I've seen some where his cymbals bang a lot faster. I've seen some where they bang a lot slower than mine. So I'm not sure how mine really ranks. I've also seen some where he hits and his cymbals actually sound like they're, like, I can't really do it, but like clinging together. Mine sounds like it's a full on just banging together. So I don't know if there's something wrong with mine or if that's just how it was. Maybe it varies toy to toy. I don't know. Also on mine, I think his mouth is supposed to close on its own when it's done. It kind of lingers open and then slowly will kind of shut, but then it'll get about that far. So when you are buying this, see as many pictures as you can. Get official word that all of his features work. Make sure his arms will cling together. Make sure his head bobs. Make sure his mouth opens. Make sure he screeches. Make sure his eyes open, or make sure his eyes pop out. make sure he works before you shell out the money for this thing. Now, with that said, he's a very, very loud toy. So if you have your volume turned up, you may want to turn down a little bit, because there's a good chance when this thing ends, I'm going to be shouting, because the last time I tried this video left my ears ringing and I think I was yelling. So bear with me here. So turn your volume down. All right. You ready? So what you do first, hit the switch, turn him on. While he's banging, just tap his head and it'll do the whole glaring thing. So let's get to it. And that's all I can really say. I'm trying not to yell, even though I want to. My ears are kind of hurting. But that's really all he does. He's a fantastic display piece. I can't recommend him for just a Toy Story collection. If you really liked the character in the movie, and if you have the means, I would say pick this guy up. He is, I think, 100% movie accurate, because they based his character, his model, off this exact toy. All the features the one in the movie has, this thing has, aside from like being able to pull its hands out of the symbols. But come on, it's a movie. We have to get past that. Of course, if you're a fan of vintage older toys, you would love this. But if you're a casual Toy Story fan, a casual collector, you really wouldn't want this, I don't think. It's for the price it goes for most of the time, I think it's really not for everybody. It's definitely not for everybody. But yeah, I would say pick it up. It is a very nice display piece. It's a great conversation piece. I've had friends over, and they'll look at it and remember it from a movie when they were younger. A movie that I haven't seen. I remember scenes from. And I'll turn it on, they'll laugh about it, and ask, why'd you get that? And then I'll talk about Toy Story, which they're like, Toy Story, he's in it? And it goes in a full conversation. It's really, really great thing to have. I'm glad I got it, and yeah, that's all I can really say. Again, if you don't want this one, you want a cheaper one, I'll post a link in the description to the Charlie Chimp. I don't have it in person, so I don't know how good it is when it's matched with this thing. But, I know its teeth will bear and that kind of stuff. So, yeah, that's it. I hope you guys have a great day, and have a fantastic Halloween. I will see you around. Take care.